Hello and welcome. Probably let's record this from that point. Hello and welcome, everybody. Thanks for joining us today. Today we're going to be talking about four cases. Then you might want to use an alternative project instead of Apache Ignite. There was three announced initially, so consider one in addition as a bonus. We will cover where you should store a PDF file, how to find something by a keyword, and how to connect your microservices between each other. How and why this talk was created, first of all. I was meeting with Ignite users before C19 situation, mostly in person, and you know, in every single audience, there's one guy who will stand up and ask, okay, Dmitry, you once again are talking about case, then Apache Ignite is absolutely perfect solution, but could you be honest and say, then Ignite is not the best fit, when you won't recommend it? And this is the topic of our talk today. My name is Dmitry Pavlov. I'm professional developer for quite a while now. I'm with Apache Ignite about 4 or 5 years. I was user, contributor, later committer in PMC, and now vice president and Apache Software Foundation officer representing Apache Ignite. I'm a committer and PPMC member at Apache Training as well. These projects, which projects aim to create training materials for different Apache and non-Apache projects, I mean, mostly open source project, to onboard new members to learn how to use it. I'm a software architect and developer at EPAM Systems, as well as trainer at EPAM Training Center. I should warn you that this talk is based on my personal opinion. I'm not speaking on behalf of the community, Apache Foundation, or EPAM Systems. And the case and the project are completely fictional. It is not related to any real projects or customers of EPAM Systems. Okay, let's get started. For which cases Apache Ignite is good for? We all more or less know about it. At least from Apache Ignite website, we know that Apache Ignite is in-memory platform. You can write and read your data. Data is distributed. You can enable persistence, use SQL queries over all data you have in the cluster. You can use Apache Ignite as simple in-memory data grid. In that case, you store all your data in memory, and most likely you will have some primary external data source. It may be database or some third-party service, just like REST HTTP, which provides you data. But if you use native persistence, and by the way, you can do it only for part of the caches, you don't need some external storage. So in that case, Apache Ignite becomes a memory database. You can cache slow database. Use Apache Ignite as a data meeting point when several sources provides some pieces of your data, and all of that pieces meet in Apache Ignite and process it there. Okay, let's move to the case. Then you'd rather implement logic somewhere else. Our example project is about notifying users about their transactions related to their accounts and all related events. Anything, just anything which requires notifications. Different users may have different available channels to be notified. One can have SMS only, another maybe, just a second, another users may have Android push notifications, and third user may have just email set up. Our settings for users are stored in traditional relational database. Imagine it is slow and or remote, so you need to go to some remote data center to get data from there. Imagine user has just logged in. Usually, user activity generates a number of notifications, so we need our settings to be available to be touched several times. So why don't we cache this user information? So this brings us to idea of caching all these settings to avoid odd requests. Let's cache record we recently loaded from database. By the way, imagine we have just about 1,000 users. We need these parameters for routing to appropriate channel. We need it just once in one service. Another service queue may have all data prepared and be ready to be sent. So why can we do it in Apache Ignite? Definitely we can. Here's an example how to set up a Gradle dependency. Now we can embed Apache Ignite into our service. Here's the code sample. We create config, ignition ignite, and that's it. We have embedded node with data. Just query some key from the cache. If we don't have it, we'll load it somehow and save back. Quite simple and straightforward, in theory. Let's cover downsides of this local cache scenario. First of all, ignition start will slow down a little bit our service. It's not a big deal for case of production. Who cares about 20 seconds in addition to start up time? But it would become pain in the neck for your local development. Over and over again, you will need to wait these 20 seconds until Apache Ignite node will start. Second of all, Apache Ignite is distributed system by design, and it will try to build a cluster and scan the network to discover some nodes. To avoid that, if you're embedding your server node, you will probably need to implement an operation discovery and something like that, or configure it somehow. By the way, Apache Ignite tests have some implementation. I'm not sure if it is available at distribution. And finally, Apache Ignite manages all entries in durable memory, which is internally based on some misconsafe. So consider that every single get will require creation of heap object. So data is in unmanaged memory, and actual result of get is always heap entry. By the way, I will leave here link about how durable memory is built under the hood. If you are interested in that topic, please check that out. And what should we use instead? For local cache, I would use a special solution, for example, Google Guava. This is a heap-only solution, so you'll always get some object every time you call get method. It's also quite simple to set it up as well. And yes, it's not scalable. You can't use other nodes or disk, but for local cache, it may overperform Apache Ignite. When is it better to still use Apache Ignite? If your services can query some data, some common subset of data, common tables and common records, is it reasonable to extract cache from embedded mode in one service and create, for example, additional container with Apache Ignite server node? By the way, you may use both techniques, distributed caching for almost full subset of data and local cache just for few recent entries. And mostly non-technical reason to prefer Apache Ignite. If your user base may increase rapidly in the nearest future, in that case, it may worth to implement all your logic once using scalable solution and later just reconfigure it. By the way, to avoid a non-heap and heap data migration, you may also use near cache technique. It is more or less heap-based cache over remote data. And for more information, check that page. That's it for case number one. And now let's implement services interaction between each other. HTTP synchronous requests are useful, but let's do it in a synchronous and scalable way. Let's set up queues. During processing of notification to be sent, service take a message from an incoming queue and put it to queue for the next one. Quite standard. And can we use Apache Ignite as a message broker? As always, we can. Apache Ignite provides messaging feature, and it is not so popular as it probably should be. It provides both unordered and unordered messages. You can choose whatever nodes to be involved into communication. It's really easy to learn and implement the very first message delivery. Here's an example. You just get a messaging API from Ignite. You set up a listener for messages, which, by the way, defines itself. Is it necessary to be subscribed further? Here we create a business object notification and put it into queue. And here we will receive an output about that message was received. It's easy, but that's not just that simple. Apache Ignite messaging doesn't provide delivery warranties. Messages are not backed up. Moreover, messages are not persisted. Even if you use Apache Ignite as a database and have persistent caches, messages are not persisted in any case. So how do you think? Is it appropriate to use this non-persistent solution for notifying users about financial information? I guess no. It may be okay for HTTP request for processing. If operation will be unsuccessful, user will just retry to do it again. It may be okay. And by the way, I was involved in such projects that actually used messaging for that case. It may be also okay if you need fewer warranties, fewer guarantees in case of power failure, less level of reliability for case of outage. What to choose for our case then? Here I would use a specific message broker, for example, Apache Kafka. And here is why. You probably need somehow monitor your service's performance, see some picture on how messages are being processed, if there is some bottleneck or not. So it may worth to use specific solution for it. You probably, and you will get at least once delivery guarantee by default. You can configure at most once as well. And all messages are persisted to a disk and may be replicated between brokers as well. One more thing, Apache Ignite and Apache Kafka, you can call it, there is more fun together. So it's better to integrate two solutions between each other. And by the way, you can use two options of doing so. Check that link for more information. And let's move to the third case. Before we move, let me check. Okay, Denis, thank you. Let's move to the third case. We need to prepare some summary for our user. Imagine we need to send, for example, a monthly report using email. Let's build our report as PDF file. We will implement generator service to generate it, additional service for encryption, for security, and finally, mail sender. Why don't we store this binary content in a cache? It seems intuitive to do so using, for example, byte array field in our entry. Let's create Ignite cache, which maps a UID to our attachment. Later, we can prepare content, some long byte array value, and save it. Simple, obvious, will pass all tests, but let's take a look to a put method, how it works. It will serialize key, get a hash code from the key, find appropriate partition, and it is more interesting to look at value-related operations. It will convert value to binary, find tree node for primary index or partition tree, and chunk all huge value to pages. Step number one, how to find appropriate place in a partition tree. Apache Ignite uses B+trees for primary and secondary indexes. Rule here is quite simple. If your key that you will place, put into the cache is less than of some found value, you go to the left. If your key is greater, you go to the right. Eventually, you will find a leaf to place a data. You can look at this structure as a linked list with additional levels, just like shortcuts to some position and that tree. For better understanding on how it works, I recommend to check that interactive visualization of how this data structure works. You can use just simple numbers there, and you can clearly see how page time merged from two into one, split it into two, or how additional levels are allocated. By the way, there is nothing affected by huge entries here, because we compare keys, not values, at least for primary index. Let's move to step number two, value processing. All data is stored in durable memory in pages. Pages equal length, chunk of data. To store a long value, we need to convert it to binary form, need to create or maybe reuse a number of pages, and finally link all these pages between each other. A call to put method for a long entry will generate a number of dirty pages or unused pages. Always dirty pages will be in our to-do list. What is to be synced to disk later? This process of flushing data to the disk is named checkpoint or checkpointing. On top of that, Apache Ignite provides ACID guarantees, so we have to maintain write-ahead lock. All these long binary value is to be there even before updating partition files. So what is the summary for blob storage case? Ignite can do it, but with significant performance impact. It's better to avoid huge entries, not only blobs, but anything with the thousands of long fields. It is also worth using SQL for updating just one field, or entry processor with keep binary cache. It is also possible to store metadata for our attachment we are going to send and in its content in separate caches. One cache would be updated just once with content, another will be used for attachment preparation steps and updated several times. Probably at some point this limitation will be outdated. There was a discussion about half a year or a year ago about supporting special blob storage functionality to store long fields outside of main entry content and somehow load it lazily. Those of you who know products for a while may ask, well, just wait a second. There is a file system in Apache Ignite. That's true. There is in-memory file system, Ignite file system, but it's quite a standalone feature. It was developed long ago and initially for Hadoop accelerator. For now, it has been voted to be excluded from the release. Code is still there, and there are no active maintainers for this feature now. And you also can check specific file-oriented solutions like Minio. And if you don't need ACID guarantees, you can just put raw files to the disk. Lower reliability, but performance will be better. Okay, let's cover the last one, the last case. When we need to find something by keyword in our cache. For our case, a good example could be a user who wants to find his or her report for notifications in the past, using simple text query. Apache Ignite has scan query, we can scan all cache content. It's quite fast for in memory, but you know, it's basically still iterator over all data. It means it is always full scan. Yes, it can be improved by additional remote filter or pre-transform data on server side, but it will touch all entries. Apache Ignite provides slightly better alternative. You can use text queries using power of Apache Lucene. To do that, you will need to declare fields to be visible in advance, just like in all other query types. You need additional dependency to be added to class path, just like all other queries, and Apache Lucene will be there. To make fields visible, it is enough to add annotation query text field. And for cache, you need to declare key and value types to be indexed in engine. That's almost it. Index for searching will be there for each node local data independently. Here's an example. We put some attachment to the cache. It contains a cache back report for August. And now we can run text search for all attachment with cacheback keyword in their names. We get a cursor from query object and here print all found entries. For our example, we'll find single entry with report from August. Everything seems to be fine, but for now, you might guess that's not entirely true. The first issue with text query is quite minor. It's not compatible with Java Jigsaw. If you have Jigsaw compatible solution, you will probably need to exclude Lucene from your dependencies. Second limitation, you don't have access to Lucene API itself. So additional features like filters are not available. But the main point why I probably discourage to use this feature, it's not possible to use it with native persistence. All data in text index is not persisted for now and lives only until restart, even for database case. The issue is not planned to be fixed. The main reason of that probably that feature is not so popular and there is no resources to develop a new integration with persistence support. Thanks to a colleague of mine, Yuri Zuliga, for implementing limit and which this feature allows you to limit results from text query. Count of these results, but as far as I know, it was the last commit to this area. Also, we've changed dependency from older to newer version only after some security issue was found in older one. It was probably a year ago. So, what is to be done in real production project? It's better not rely on built-in integration, but use both products and probably integrate them. There are two options. Offload data and all changes, I mean, increments on data to, for example, Apache Solr cluster. And slightly more advanced option to integrate with Apache Lucene library itself. If you choose option two, it is possible that you will be able to contribute something back to the Apache Ignite code base, or at least you can create your blog post or run a talk. I encourage you to do so. And also, if you use Apache Ignite and see something that can be improved, feel absolutely free to say hi to the community and offer some help. You can also check that link here to see how to join. You may be surprised how welcoming and open forks are there. Okay, let's sum it up. Then Apache Ignite is not applicable or has limits. As a distributed cache, Apache Ignite is good, but as a local cache, if scalability and persistence are not required, it's better to prefer local cache solution, for example, Google Guava. For querying text or as a message broker, Apache Ignite can be used, but I would recommend to use specified, for example, Apache products for that cases, and integrate products between each other. I really hope that you like that and the talk was useful for you. Should you have any questions related to products, as always, feel free to ask at user my link list, and don't forget to help others and share your experience. And anything related to contributions is discussed by developers in positive and constructive way at the dev list. And I would appreciate your feedback and your ideas on cases then you'd rather select an alternative project. Thank you for your attention and have an absolutely fantastic day.
So it's time for questions.
We have a use case from a cluster of 50 nodes, 3 server nodes and others client. These three server nodes will act as data source and a native persistence is used. Server node can be restarted, then client is storing data to the cache. Does Ignite ensure strong consistency in case of server restarts? Sometimes we observed cache misses due to issues on forming baseline topology. My best guess that usually server restart should not affect data consistency. Okay. It actually depends on settings. Maybe in some cases you might lose some entries because, you know, if you're not waiting for all nodes to respond and you shut down nodes immediately, just like in cutoff, it may be that in some cases some recent puts will be not there just because of, you know, your boot method is not configured to wait all nodes to respond. So I guess it needs a little bit more details to cover.
I think it's better to maybe email to user list. I'm sure that someone will help with that.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Of course, we also answer at Stack Overflow. Many Ignite developers paying attention to questions about Ignite on Stack Overflow, but better for user list because there are a lot of people who have Ignite in production and they're happy to share their experience.
Yeah, I guess the ideal scenario then users communicate directly to each other and share experience. It's absolutely perfect scenario for community building up.
If you are not subscribed, you should. That's interesting. And by the way, if someone has Ignite in production, we would be happy to invite you as a speaker to one of our next virtual meetups. Because it's always interesting to listen to someone who uses that in different environments and in different cases.
Yeah, definitely. I guess it shouldn't be some absolutely success story. There, everything is fine. It's quite natural to share positive things. We managed to do it. It may be some issues, some challenges, some maybe even problems. With workarounds, it's still helpful for others. If you facing with some issue that most likely someone else have seen this issue before.
That's how a roadmap is being done, I would say. By the way, if you're interested, what will be the next major release of Apache Ignite 3.0, you can join the presentation of our release engineer, Valentin Kulichenko. That will be next Tuesday. And he'll present general changes which are planned using the wish list. And the wish list, of course, was made by people who use that in production.
By the way, will Valentin lead release itself? I mean, will Valentin be a release manager?
Yeah, he's a release manager this time. Yes, absolutely. That's why we asked him to present major changes which are planned at the moment, because the wish list was really great and a lot of things were put down to the next release. Let's put it back to the next release, to the next, and here we've got really long list of wishes. And he's trying at the moment to make it a short list for playing. And everything of that you can find on dev list, because in Apache Software Foundation, all such questions, they are public and they are on mailing list. It's a main channel of communication.
Maybe someone from you have an idea that when you would not use Apache Ignite, probably in the future, we will be able to develop this topic with limitation of product. Share something additional.
So please unmute and share if you have something about that. Don't hesitate. Or if you have other questions about Ignite, maybe. At the moment we can, I think, spend some minutes. While people are answering the poll, at least.
Isn't anyone working on non-JVM language integration with Ignite? Question is
Hi,
Closure Fun.
I'm Balakiran. I'm basically from Bangalore, India. So we are using Ignite in our pre-production environment as of now, but we are facing one random error occasionally, right? So our microservices are based on .NET, hosted in IIS, right? So for some reasons, Ignite client, I mean, which is part of IIS by default, is getting disconnected with server, right, with grid, but it is not getting reconnected automatically. We have verified whether it is a JVM pause or any issues with the memory, heap memory configuration, etc. That's not the case, and we have verified whether there is any network glitch that caused the disconnection between this client and server. And that is also not the case. This happens randomly once in a 2 weeks or a 3 weeks, not so frequently. And this is a kind of little inconvenience that we have. Do you have any idea or suggestions where should we look into to solve this problem?
Unfortunately, off the top of my head, I don't have ideas how to fix it. But I do remember that some time ago, a few issues with Reconnect were fixed by community, so I guess it may worth to try the latest version we have.
think we have 2.7 as of now. Yeah, we'll see. We'll try
2.9.1, I would say.
Yeah, 2.9.1, the latest one. Okay. It's quite probable that this issue was fixed. Yeah, there was a question about supporting non-Java languages integration, and actually the latest versions of Apache Ignite has quite well specified binary integration protocol which allows you, hopefully easy, create some additional client to that platform. And we have .NET, we have Python, we have something else. I don't remember all these languages because there are a number of them. But we have PHP. Yes, thank you, Denise. But I'm not sure that Clojure is under work. Maybe it is a good case to come to the community and contribute some into integration. It's really simpler that doing all lowly level stuff in B+ trees and pages and all like that.
Are there any changes in thin client in recent version? I mean, do we have some kind of limitations in terms of handling this? Split brain scenarios with thin clients? But that was more of a handleable situation with thick clients. I'm just looking for a non-JVM based thin client. I mean, thin client does not have a JVM. That's what my understanding. So, but that does have some limitations. Are there any improvements in thin client in the recent version?
Actually, I don't quite get the question. Thin client may be based on JVM as well. We have Java thin client. I'm not sure if client implementation really affects split brain scenario, because in split brain server nodes should decide themselves if it's safe to operate or should we disable.
Thanks, guys. And I will also appreciate any ideas about the talks and speakers you would like to see here next time. And I hope that someone of you will be our speaker once about using the Apache Ignite, because really your story don't need to be super successful or super fantastic or super complicated.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with that. And I really hope that some of you will became committers and joined the community, not only talking about your experience, but also participating in development, maybe for client or for Clojure.
Yeah, or just join the user list and help other users to get where you are into the internals. What kind of intro do you mean here? Like using the Apache Ignite in production, or like creating apps using Apache Ignite? Oh, developer centric, you mean how to become a committer? Yes, I think that we have such talk, and we can, Dmitry, can you repeat this talk for us, for example, in November maybe?
Definitely, I can.
Dmitry has a talk about principles of being part of Apache Software Foundation, and I think that we'll do one. Also, we have some newbie tickets, and we can ask guys to introduce them, the model maintainers, and create a little chat for people who would like to try to contribute. So let's think about that for November.
Yes, that sounds like a good idea to invite some maintainers to not only cover principles, but cover details related to particular task, particular model?
Yeah, like what and why and where it will be. Because I think it's not so easy for a newcomer to just read the JIRA and choose the ticket. Thank you, everyone, for participating. Thank you for coming. Please join the group if you are not yet in our meetup group. Join our next meeting next week, next Tuesday, about Apache Ignite next version. And Dmitry, I hope to see you too.
Yeah, thank you everybody for joining. We are a little bit tired of online, but still you are here. Thank you for your time and take care.
Yeah, bye-bye. Take care.